7, the first time someone told me I was American, the first time someone compared my dad to Osama bin Laden, I was 10, and the first time someone called me a terrorist, it was my 13th birthday. I remember my voice shrinking in shock, the audacity to even utter such words, my face red, hot. I remember my eyes welling up with 6 years of frustration. Today, when you ask, where are you from, I stare directly back at you and answer, here. You get upset when I sit for the pledge, tell me to act more American as if it wasn't you who made me think I'm not American in the first place, but I guess that's why you use the word act. You refer to my hijab as just a piece of cloth, but if I would say the same thing about your flag, your hands would form fists and fingers would wrap around you. You tell me, go back to your country. Then, when I try, hold me back for random security checks or get me kicked off the plane, I'm labeled dangerous on the news, but I am victim to your abuse, getting screamed at gas stations and followed in the streets. Your president signs a Muslim ban. Then you ask why my family doesn't celebrate the 4th of July. I don't know where to go anymore. Don't know if it's real when I feel my neighborhood loving me or if I've imagined it this whole time. When did the change happen? When did you decide I was no longer to be blocked out but forced to claim America as my home? What made you want me? What made you think twice about spitting me out? Maybe it's this platform I have found. This community of survivors fighting to right your wrongs. Maybe it's the way my hijab blows in the wind like a cape or rapid hummingbird wings making the noise of revolution. Growing up, I was taught to keep quiet, never cause any disruptions. But I was also taught to always tell the truth. And I don't know which to do anymore because the words truth and disruption have become a merging road. I was also taught to never make anyone uncomfortable. My very existence defined in a way that feels like hot wax on your skin. But see, the thing is that if this makes you uncomfortable, you are part of the problem. You expect me to pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, the country that has been rejecting my family since they got here. The flag, that piece of cloth that you hold as close to you as if it were a piece of your identity. And maybe it is, and maybe I can respect that, but if and only when you learn that this piece of cloth on my head is just as holy, and these words that have traveled so far and so long to get here, through oceans of ink and roads of paper, and God knows through how many red lights. There is nothing more American than the desire of change than standing up for what you believe in. And if America is what you say it is, then there is nothing, nobody more American than me.
Makes you think, right?